Wanted to talk just for a moment about the hardened HF antenna. This is it right here. This acts as a backup antenna for the one out near the parking lot, that great big, looks like a cage almost. You've probably seen it if you've been out here to the museum. It's hard to miss. That antenna would easily be destroyed in a nearby nuclear strike, so we have to have a backup. And this is it. This is a telescoping antenna. Actually, it telescopes up out of the ground. It's kept in its own hardened silo here. And there's a blast plug for the maintenance hatch right here, and so you need to take that off. It's extremely heavy. We've already taken it out, but if you needed to do that, you put a block and tackle right here and attach it to the blast plug, and out it goes. The weather cover is a lot lighter than that. So we're going to pull the cover off here and go down inside and take a look. I've asked Norm, one of our ace docents, to help me do this. So Norm, if you would unscrew the bolt there, and we'll just go to your left with this.
Okay.
And there we go, right over about there. That's cool. Good. All right. Thank you, Norm. All right, we'll head down inside and see what this looks like. Fortunately, this antenna does not collect Black Widow spiders the way the General Electric antenna does. A lot of ways to hit your head down here. So that's where we came from. And the ladder goes down here and keeps going all the way down. It's about 30 feet to the bottom of the silo. And there's really nothing down there except the dehumidifier, and looks like a bucket of something down there. But the antenna is right here. And you can see the general idea here is that these rubber tires will grip the telescoping part of the antenna and just pull it right on up, and then the pieces lock together on the way up. There's a local control panel right here, and then to get the antenna hatch open, there's a pressurized nitrogen gizmo right here. We have some historic video that was shot about 30 years ago of this antenna actually moving. So let's switch to that. All right, the only other thing I'd like to point out is that this entire antenna structure or mechanism is hanging on springs. So just like everything else around here, this is shock isolated. This needs to be able to withstand the effects of a nearby nuclear strike. Well, let's head back up topside. So there you go, quick little primer on the HF hardened antenna. Thanks for watching.